Today, I discuss stepwise regression. As in linear regression, there is step up, that is forward selection method. Step down, that is backward elimination method. And third is stepwise method. In step up procedure, first we fit the intercept only model or some other relatively simple model that includes only imported explanatory variables or covariates. Next, fit all models that add an additional covariate to the model in one choose the model fits significantly better. Say if the p value for extra covariate is less than 0.05, keep this covariate in. If not, you might stop with the current model. Third, repeat these steps until you want to stop. In step down process, starts with a very complex model and then tries to delete covariate or covariates that help the list. Note that you may also elect to include all the covariates interactions. However, this may result in many required iteration to get back to a suitable model. Stepwise method it is the combination of step down and step up. That is, here we try to step up or step down tandem at each step. Note that there are other variable selection techniques available. For example, Hausman For example, Hosmer Lemoso suggest best subset regression as an alternative strategy. Next note, once you have come up with your best model, you want to consider the goodness of the fit of the model you have selected, and method is the goodness of fit statistics are the same as those discussed in our earlier videos. Recall this goodness of fit statistics, and you can fit a more general model with including interaction term and quadratic terms, etc., and see if the extra terms are, if the extra terms are significant. Next, the deviance or Pearson's chi-square can be used if the strata sample sizes are sufficient, that is more than equal to 75% of ni greater than equal to 10, which I already discussed in my previous video. However, If this condition does not satisfy, in that case we use Hosmer-Lemoussos procedure. So this is the method to select influential or important covariates or explanatory variables. Before ending this topic, I discuss another criterion, that is AIC. In selecting a model, we are mistaken if we think that we have found the true one. Any model is a simplification of reality. For instance, width does not exactly have a linear effect on the probability of satellites. Whether we use the logit link or identity link, what is the logic of testing the fit of model when we know that it does not truly hold? A simple model has relatively little bias. Describing reality well, it tends to provide more accurate estimates of the quantities of interest. Other criteria besides significance test can help select a good model in terms of estimating quantities of interest. The best known is information criterion, in short AIC. It judges a model how close its fit or how close its fitted values tend to be the true value or true values in terms of a certain expected value, even though a simple model is further from the true model than is a more complex model, it may be preferred because it tends to provide better estimates of certain characteristics of the true model, such as sale probabilities. Thus, optima model is the one that tends to have fit, optima model tends to have fit closest to reality. Given a sample, Akaek showed that this criterion selects the model that minimizes -2 into maximized log likelihood minus number of parameters in model. This term is AIC. This penalized a model for having many parameters, with model for categorical Y, this ordering is equivalent to one based on an adjustment of the deviance g square minus 2 df by twice its residual degrees of freedom. That is, this is deviance minus 2 into residual degrees of freedom. So the criteria is you minimized AIC, which is minus 2 into maximized log likelihood minus number of parameters in model which is equivalently minimize g square into 2 into degrees of freedom. So this is all about strategies in model selection. We will discuss next topic, that is the issue of missing observations and over dispersed model, in our next lectures. Before starting this topic, I illustrate logistic regression with some example via R language. So please, till then, please stay with us. Thank you.